At the southern tip of Africa lies a landscape like no other. A place almost more of myth and legend than fact. This spectacular region supports life unlike anywhere else in the world. A veritable menagerie of astonishing flora and fauna. And perhaps most remarkable of all, our lion dogs. Lion dogs have roamed this land for centuries. They put fear into the heart of most whom they come across. They stalk the plains, apex predators with nothing to fear. The lion dog social system is well developed and typically matriarchal. The males are submissive toward the females. However, sometimes one needs to pay obeisance to one's matriarch. One has to show that one is loyal. Notice this pandering activity from a young male towards his sovereign. Notice also how conspicuously indifferent she is. This digging behavior serves several functions. The cooler sand beneath the surface serves to cool down a lion dog's hot blood after the hunt, and also shows the submission he's required to in order to stay alive. Indeed, it's hot work being a lion dog on the Cape Peninsula, basking in the blazing African sun, can understandably lead to fatigue, and so sometimes rest is needed. The indigenous fynbos of the area provides at least some shade for these denizens of the dunes, taking pride of place at the bottom, where the shade is thicker and the air cooler. The queen rests, breathing heavily as she shores up strength for her next hunt, or courtship, or walkie. Above, where the air is still warmer, the space is occupied by the submissive male, whose tongue serves a valuable thermoregulatory process, as does his vacant skull. This is indeed a remarkable place, and these are indeed remarkable creatures. It is not only a wild haven, but it's also a residential treasure. This modern city is home to 4 million people who live alongside the mighty lion dog, enjoying an enviable lifestyle betwixt nature and city, and between the ancient and the modern. One may ask, how do people live side by side with Africa's mighty lion dogs? How do these mighty creatures tolerate humans? The answer is quite remarkable. They've been domesticated. Even within the confines of domestic life, lion dogs follow the same social structures and courtship rituals they do in the wild. Some kissing, a jump, now a stretch. Acceptance by the dominant matriarch, but this is only confirmed if one dances well enough. A wag of the tail, a stomp of the feet. This tap dancing behavior is not only peculiar to the species, but is highly erotic for the female. Notice how she accepts the male, and they perform this pre-coital behavior of kissing one another. A nibble here and there. Once again, the submissive posture. Jaws around the throat. Oftentimes, the female will crush the male before allowing any more. Lion dogs are found in a wide variety of habitats upon the southern peninsula. The beaches are often littered with their footprints, Here, they can run as nature intended. Here, they are free, born free, living free. The waves crash as they have for eons, and the feet of lion dogs pound the sand as they have for ages. These lion dogs are our heritage, and it's up to us to protect them so that future generations can also enjoy the lion dogs of the Cape Peninsula.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like this video, subscribe to the channel.